8.0. That'll do for now. And welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, you should go hit the subscribe button. So I'm very much into old cameras and product photography, and with my little collection that I have of old cameras, I've never ever thought about actually taking pictures of them for some reason. And for this video, I was thinking I should show you how I do it and what methods I do. I don't say it's the right way to go, but certainly not the wrong way. It's not the first time I do product photography. I've done it a couple times before on this channel. But this time I'm gonna try to go down on details, how I think when I do it and which way I go and how I light it a little bit. I don't have a lot of cool lights and special effects, but I do the best of what I have. So there's two cameras that I'm gonna try to photograph today, actually. It's a 620 Brownie. It's made by Kodak. It's a really old camera, which hopefully looks cool. The other one is a Minolta, I think it's called. I think that's how you say it. It's a 2.8 38mm lens. Two old cameras. One is from my mom, and the other one from my grandma. I don't know where she probably found this old one. She probably found that at some secondhand store, I'll guess. But it's a cool looking camera, so that's what I'm going to try to take. Other thing, maybe I should tell you what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use my G9 as usual. I don't have anything else to use. I'm gonna use the G9 to take the pictures. And I don't know what lens I will do, maybe 35 or 50. I haven't really decided yet. I think I'll try both of them. A couple of things when I take portrait or product photography, I try to light the subject from like a 45 degree angle. Pretty much the same thing as I do here. I use a light right there to light me up, get this side a little bit darker. As you can tell, I don't know when that turned off, but I'll show you one thing. It's empty, the battery died. But I light something up in the background like this. Either that light or this light. I have something in the background showing off the background a little bit. But when I do portrait or product, I put one light, a hair light, or I do something that lights up the background like that. And what I've tried to do, as I said, I don't know if it's right. I do it because I like the way it looks. If I have the main light coming from this direction, I try to keep the hair light from this direction, the opposite side of the main light. Either if it's portrait or product, I always try to center. Even when I do landscape, I like to center something. I have one something in the center on. Just because I said that, I feel like I'm not entirely centered right now. Now I am. I think the camera's a little bit tilted, but that's the way I work. I don't know, some people probably say it's wrong, but I like it and I like the way it looks, so I'll keep doing it till it's something change and if I find a better way. If you don't have a lot of work with, like I have two lights, two main lights, I can't change the colors, I can't do pretty much. I can light them up, I can turn the Kelvin, I can turn on the brightness, but nothing more. I have a lume cube that I use for like a little backlight, but that's it. I don't have any special effects. For me, it all works fine. So I'll see you in a bit, and hopefully we can build up a cool scene and get some tiny shots.
When you forget to
empty your memory card. Now you need to wait. It sucks. I forgot telling you one thing. If you don't have lights at all, just use a window. It works perfect. Get pictures like this. So, if you don't have a huge studio like mine, it's a pretty tight one. Do the best of the situation, just find something. Probably use a wider angle lens so you can get closer to the subject, so you don't need to back off as much. If you have lights, make sure to turn the subject towards the light. It looks better. Another thing you should do is to match the Kelvin. It's way easier to edit afterwards. Try to do different angles of the photo. With a macro lens, you can get closer up to the subject, and with a 24-70, you can get even closer up with a wide angle. So it looks like this. So that's all I can give you. Some key points from the shoot should be using some sort of light, like even if it's constant light, like this light, a flash, or even natural light. But make sure to match Kelvin with the light. Most cameras have settings to do shady, cloud, sunlight, LED light. If you don't have that settings, just try to match as good as you can. Another key point is to frame the subject, or the object in this case. Put something in the foreground, put something in the background, make it pop out a little bit more by using that technique. And the way I like to go with it is just, as I said, add something to the scene. Start off empty and build your way up. If you have a plan that's even better, you can go that way. But if you don't have a solid plan, just start off empty, find something to match the object. If you can and have the possibility to use a macro lens, you should definitely try to use it. It's so easy to get those close-up detailed shots of something. And the last one, angles. Try different angles. Take a top-down picture from the side, straightforward, it doesn't matter. Try different angles, it helps. And that way you can see what looks best. Well, yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Like the video, go sub to the channel, and I hope to see you in the next video. Peace out. Oh, by the way, go follow me on Instagram. It would be awesome if you did that.